What can you expect from the express entry cutoffs? Is it going to go high? What do I think of it? How does the stack of people in the pool, how does the pool representation look like? Here's my take on that particular discussion today. We're almost at the end of the first quarter of 2021 and things are looking a little different than they were looking in the start of the year. Well, still, please watch the video till the end. My name is Sahil. So guys, welcome back once again. My name is Sahil and I'm a regulated Canadian immigration consultant and I practice in Brampton, Ontario. My office is there and right now I'm traveling to India. So if you have to get in touch with me, my number is on the screen and in the description box. Please feel free to send me a WhatsApp message, and if you have to get in touch with me during my Indian tour, my Indian number is on the screen for your information. Guys, if you are watching me for the first time, if you're on this channel for the first time, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell icon, because every time we release a new video on Canadian immigration, you will be the first one who receives a notification and update and you don't miss any update. Guys, so we are discussing a very important topic today, which is around what do you expect in terms of the upcoming draws? What is the future of express entry for the year 2021? How does the pool representation look like and what can you expect? Guys, I receive a ton of calls every day wherein people say that I'm sitting at 465, 450, 430, 300 something. What do you think is going to happen? What do you think the cutoffs are going to go high? What cutoffs are going to go low? A lot of federal skilled candidates have been sitting in the pool for almost 3 months. The first quarter is almost ending. We haven't seen any federal skilled worker cutoffs so far in this year. Guys, so if you look at the pool representation so far in the table that is shared by IRCC on their express entry page, the pool representation, the table clearly shows how many people are sitting in the pool at this moment. And through that particular table, you can very well estimate what is the sort of representation we are expecting. Guys, the table is fresh as of March 15th, and I'm going to give you just the numbers so that we can expect what is going to come up next. If you look at candidates over the CRS score of 500, we have about 1869 candidates already sitting in the pool. Okay, so essentially these people could be either PNP candidates or people with, you know, maybe an LMIA, or people with French, people with, you know, 00 LMIAs as well, people who are scoring a lot higher. Now, if you look at the pool, which is above 451 and 500, so in that bracket, the overall composition is about 29,648. So technically, over 451 CRS, 29,000 approximately people are there, or say 30,000 people are already there. Further breaking down, if you look at the pool above 461, okay, now let's look at the pool above 471. Now if you look at 471, there are about 9,696 people, so approximately 9,700 people, okay. And then between 461 and 470, another 9,837. Okay, so with this figure in mind, if you were to look at the previous draws in 2020, even if you know, IRCC goes on inviting say 5,000 candidates per draw, okay, now 5,000 candidates invited means if you go by top down, top 1869 above 500, then 9,700 above 470, and then comes 461 to 470. So roughly, if you go by the estimate, above for federal skilled worker only, the cutoff should be sitting still above 470. This is what we're estimating. Not sure, because this sort of a cutoff definitely depends upon a lot of things, like what kind of candidates are there? Are they FST mainly, or they CEC as in like Canadian Experience Class, or are they PNP candidates? Okay, and now since Canada IRCC has been inviting a lot of Canadian Experience Class and PNPs, so obviously the top stack goes on, you know, vacating, the people go on vacating the pool and moving out with their invitations, and then every now and then more people keep on adding up. Okay, and then federal skilled worker, since there have been no draws for the past 3-4 months, people have been waiting in the pool, and once the draw comes out, how many people are invited, you know, in that particular draw, or maybe one or two draws, that is going to drastically affect the points or the CRS cutoff that is going to arrive. But for now, the points which we are seeing, Canadian experience class recently happened at 449. That is a good score. But if you look at there was another notification that about, you know, a major chunk of the people sitting in the pool of them are Canadian experience class. Okay, so with that in mind, federal skilled worker, you could, you know, we don't have a clear bifurcation as to how many federal skilled workers are there, but somewhat the same score. We don't expect a major fall, at least for the next one or two draws of federal skilled worker. Let's see how the federal skilled worker pans out during the second or the third quarter of this particular year. Guys, COVID-19 has taken things on a different level, on a different chapter altogether. And, we were expecting, and never had we seen Canadian experience class being invited at 75 only. Well, that was the lowest of, the cutoff in the history of IRCC, but that still happened. IRCC has been taking all the necessary measures to curb the impacts of COVID-19. So if we are, we might be expecting a surprise every now and then, and we've seen that IRCC does anything, very differently in order to affect people positively at large. So we can definitely expect IRCC to help a lot of applicants, especially they do say that Canadian experience class are, you know, ready to merge with the economy better than FSW. So that is why we have been seeing that a lot of Canadian experience class and PNP candidates have been invited already. So with that in mind, we can expect a lot of surprises in the upcoming second quarter and the third quarter, but we don't know. IRCC, we can only predict, but usually what we have seen, our prediction generally goes, so nobody predicted 75 cutoff of Canadian experience class, right? So with IRCC, it is only expectation and hope. There is no prediction as such. We can only hope that this happens, but prediction, we don't know. Only IRCC knows what's going to happen. Guys, I hope this sort of breakup of situation and this sort of a breakup of table helped you understand the composition of the pool of candidates which are already there, because it's really important for you to know how you are placed and what can you expect in the future, because you can then take necessary actions of upgrading your score. It could be either going in for a work permit or a study permit or maybe for French or PNP or anything, but at least looking at the composition, you can prepare your strategy. Okay, and that definitely is going to affect you at large, because if your age is increasing, you could take alternate measures to see when and how you will be invited, right? Guys, I hope the information was helpful. It definitely gave you certain insights. If you still need to get in touch with me, have a one-to-one conversation. More than happy to speak to you. Please book a consultation. My number is on the screen. You can send us a WhatsApp message on the Canadian number or give us a regular call on the Indian number while I'm traveling to India till the month of April. I'm here in India. Once again, it was lovely chatting with you. I hope to see you soon in Canada, and all the best.